Well, we're joined now by Neil Long, who is chief executive of the charity Sands, who published a report, and also by Jackie Veitch, whose baby boy was stillborn at 33 and a half weeks. Thank you both for coming in, especially to you, Jackie, because it's such a difficult topic to talk about. We appreciate you being prepared to do so. Just tell us what happened to you.
I had terrible food poisoning. I felt dreadful. I didn't feel any movement from the baby. The baby was actually a very busy baby, having had a couple since. So the next morning I phoned my doctor and she said, kind of take it easy for 24 hours. I assumed that the baby felt as terrible as me, but actually the next morning when he still wasn't moving, I went into hospital and they couldn't find a heartbeat.
And was there any explanation? Did the doctors relate it to the food poisoning?
Well, we think that's probably what's happened. I mean, we've tried to sort of piece it together after the event, because my pregnancy was progressing perfectly normally as far as I was aware. I was fit and healthy and had no idea that this sort of thing could happen.
And so did you feel, had you been given any warning that this was at all possible?
No, none at all. I had absolutely no idea.
And it clearly, it's a devastating experience.
Yes, it is. I mean, it's changed me. It's taken me, it's almost 3 years ago now, and I'm starting to feel sort of normal again, but that process took a very long time. I felt sort of completely severed from real life for a long time afterwards.
And luckily, you have been able to have children since.
I have, yeah. I now have another two. I had a little boy about a year after my firstborn.
And you must have been terrified with that pregnancy.
I was, yeah, I was a bit of a wreck. And I sort of withdrew. I just sort of hibernated as much as I could and hoped that the days would pass and that he'd still be alive. And it was a magical day when he was born and was alive.
And Neil, turning to you, I mean, that story, you must have heard so many stories, all of them different. Such a startling figure, though. 17 babies every day lost, stillborn, or in the first few days after birth.
The figure is absolutely stunning. Putting it into context, we're talking about 6,500 babies every year in the UK. That's four times the number of people who die from MRSA and twice the number of parents, of adults, who die on Britain's roads. So what we want to see is that this is a national health problem and must be given a politically national priority.
And do you think there isn't enough political emphasis given to it?
I think there's a lot of very good initiatives going into maternity services as a whole, but there isn't a focus on stillbirths and neonatal deaths. The tendency too often is that this problem is just swept under the carpet.
And is it possible that the figures are getting no better over the past 10 years because actually the health factors, older mums, more obesity, all of these things are actually working against?
Well, the neonatal figures are getting better. The stillbirth figures are very stubbornly not changing and haven't done for 10 years. There, of course, are those factors in there. But what we feel is that you've got a number of factors really need to be taken into account if you're going to build a proper national strategy to drive down the stillbirth and neonatal death rate. And they've got to be much better resources. Realistically, at the moment, both the maternity and antenatal services are overstretched. We need real research monies going in. We think it doesn't need huge sums, potentially something like $6 million, of which SANS can invest up to a half, because we've got so many parents fundraising for us. And that $3 million that we're looking for, you have to take that in context again, that the NHS Litigation Authority is having to pay out $300 million in maternity-related clinical negligence cases.
Well, that figure puts it all in perspective. Neil, Jackie, we have to leave it there, but thanks so much to both of you for coming in.
Thank you.